study first topic for this session. Let us see what a dividend is all about. Well, different investors get different forms of returns, like debenture holders get interest payment, preference shareholders get preference dividend, equity shareholders get equity dividend. And this is what equity dividend is the purpose of study now. So what is dividend? It is, you can say, it refers to the profit which is available for distribution among the shareholders. It is also termed as a part of the profits of a business concern which is distributed among the shareholders. Now, different people also give different definitions of dividend, but the most appropriate, which is a distribution to shareholders out of profits and reserves available for this purpose. So, when equity shareholders are the real owners of the company and they take certain risk element in your company and they want certain returns as well. Now, why is dividends a purpose of study? So, dividends are a purpose of study. Why? Because, for example, you see, when profits are distributed, earnings available to shareholders, the ultimate profit is left for distribution to the equity shareholders. Over here, we decide how much profits are to be distributed and how much profits are to be retained back, right? So these two decisions come over here. For example, if 100% of the profits which are available for distribution, I say 80% will give us dividend, 20% will be retained back, right? The 20% equity shareholders money I just can't keep back in the business. I need their consent. And the why I'm keeping the money back or plowing back the profits back in the business in the form of retained earnings, I need to give them a suitable reason for the same. And if they're actually okay with it, yes, you can go ahead, then all you can keep that money. Now, for example, various companies, like you can see Airtel. Bharti Airtel, when it wanted to become the major telecommunication company like 10 years back, now they were very clear, they wanted to go and acquire companies, and for that they need money. So what they did, they come and put a proposal to the shareholder. They say, we will not give you profits for some year in the form of dividends because we need some retained earnings. But what happened? Equity shareholders declined. They said, no, we won't give you a part with the profits because we don't feel the way you are putting your money is a good one for us. Our value will not be maximized. Now, why did shareholders not agree that time? Because Airtel was trying to acquire a bigger company in size, that was it. I don't know how many of you heard about the company. Shareholders declined of Airtel because they thought a bigger company coming into picture, their shareholding will go down. As you say, who become a shareholder or a director who has a major shareholding? And if a bigger company come, their directors will have a more say in the company than these directors. And these people actually completely say no, they won't part with their money in the form of retained earnings because they don't find their value maximizing in the long run. So what happened after a period of time, Bharti Airtel went and acquired some other company, smaller size than Zen. Now that time shareholders agreed. And if you see, the major part of the deal was financed through retained earnings and loan from ICICI. So they didn't bothered about shares, debentures. They were very clear. We have self-sufficient, we have money, we have accumulated all the years. And now what is happening, we are using that money, the remaining portion of deal we are financing is to loan from ICICI. Now this is what dividend decisions are all about. And when you are giving dividends in the form of profits, you're retaining back also some. See, a company like owners need to contribute for the risk element. These owners also, when they're giving back the profit, because the business belongs to them and the owner, they are supposed to take risk. Now, when they are taking risk in the company, they should be actually convinced that if they're parting with their money today, the money gives them a sufficient return. You studied in the cost of capital. The cost of retained earnings is always equal to cost of equity. Why? Because if these people are parting with their money today, at least they want the same return on their profits which are reinvested, the same return which they were getting under cost of equity. There's a very important decision we need to make under dividends now. So dividend policies we'll see as such, what are the various factors affecting it now? The various factors which affect the dividend policy of a company. Now, the first major factor which affects the dividend policy of a company is the legal restrictions. Now if you see, Companies Act has very clearly actually specified in India that the dividends can only be paid out of current year profits or reserves or past accumulated reserves which you have any. Apart from that, dividend cannot be paid from any other source. So we have legal restrictions also, how and from where we can pay the dividends. Similarly, magnitude and trend of the earnings also impacts the dividend policy. For example, higher the profits, higher will be the dividends paid to the shareholders. Lower the profits, lower the dividend you'll be paying. Similarly, what type of shareholders also you have also impacts. So desire and type of shareholders also impacts your dividend policy. For example, what if more of your shareholders are retired persons, senior citizens? They won't be okay with the retained earnings. They'll say, you give us at least something every year. Right? Whatever are savings we have invested in your company, the impact is like constability in their earnings. But then you can't say we won't give you dividend for some years because we want to go and merge with some other company. So what type of shareholders you have also impacts your dividend policy. Similarly, what type of nature of industry you are. Nature of industry, for example, you are into some like IT. This impacts, for example, how your industry is major, you can say, reacting to economic turmoil, economic fluctuations. For example, certain companies like banking. We know, even if recession happens, pharma company is something which won't go much because people won't stop focusing on healthcare. Healthcare industry is something, boom happens, recession happens in economy, healthcare will be something. People won't stop taking care of their health as such. So what type of industry it is? It impacts your earnings and it impacts upon the dividend policy. Now I agree, pharma sector, healthcare sector, there's a lot of regulations, right? Like Cipla and other RANBACs, when they export drugs in US, there's a lot of, you can say, restrictions over them, and for them many companies were banned also because of it, because they could not follow the guidelines or they didn't have the normal quality check controls which were required to be there. They have normal guidelines which we need to keep in mind, but we know healthcare industry is some industry which people won't stop focusing on. So what type of industry is also into matters a lot. Similarly, age of the company. You study the life cycle of a company, maybe in marketing, introduction, maturity, decline, right, growth. So introduction, growth, maturity, decline, talk about the life cycle of a company. At what stage a company is today matters. See, in the introduction stage, a new startup company, first of all, may not have so many profits to give dividend. Reaching a break-even point will only take them so much time. So, age of the company matters. Maybe in the growth stage or a maturity stage, companies are able to actually give you profits. So, age of the company matters a lot. Similarly, future financial requirements like Bharti Airtel. They were very clear when they say they want to go and acquire a company. And they had a reason. They had a viable reason why they are asking you to part with your money as well. So, your future financial requirements, why do you want certain money? Why do you want the retained earnings to happen? Why are you not giving them dividends? Everything impacts a lot when you start talking about dividend policies. Taxation policy of the company as well. If you see EBIT minus interest was PBT, PBT minus tax was PAT. And see, tax reduces your profits, which are available to distribution to the equity shareholders. So, tax element impacts your profits. What the taxation policy you have in your company. Similarly, all these factors contribute a lot to the, when we talk about as a dividend policies of a company, and equity shareholders are impacted by all of them, and company in sense, in short, whether they have to pay dividend or whether they can keep back and retain earnings, all these factors contribute to it.